Hey everybody, it's Alexa from Berks Nostalgia, and today I'm going to take you on a little exploration of the old Trexler mansion, which then became the Reading Elks Lodge building. The mansion sits at 5th and Franklin Streets in Reading and was built in 1869 by a businessman named Horatio Trexler. Trexler lived in the property and used it as a private residence until he died in 1900. In 1904, his beneficiaries sold the property off to the Reading Elks Club, Lodge 115. The Elks home almost immediately started making improvements to the property. In 1909, a $50,000 addition was constructed onto the back of the original mansion. This addition included a dining hall on the main level, above it the main meeting hall, and above that a rooftop garden which had an occupancy for 300 people to be seated. You're going to get to see those rooms a little bit later on in this video, amongst a ton of other really cool stuff. There's actually a 4-lane bowling alley in the basement of this place that the Elks put in shortly after they bought it, so yeah, they definitely use this place for some luxury and fun, and I imagine that they had some seriously good times here. After 75 years, the Elks ended up selling the building in 1979 privately, and since then it's just been various businesses that owned it, and it's probably been abandoned for at least a decade. In May 2021, it was announced that Schumann Development Group purchased this property with the intention to redevelop it into event space in conjunction with their Abe Lincoln Hotel and the Bear Chapel, which is about a block away. But besides that, I'm not going to talk too much. I'm just going to let this walking tour speak for itself. And if you want to know a little bit more about the history, I will be linking an article that I wrote on that in the description. So check that out if you want to know more.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
As usual, thank you all so much for watching. I just want to give a special thank you to Alan Schumann of Schumann Development Group for allowing me access to this building so I could take all these shots. I'm sure they're going to do a fantastic job with this place, and I can't wait to see it. And maybe when they're done, we can get some after shots. Hope you all enjoyed the video. If you did, give it a big old thumbs up and follow us on Instagram and Facebook for more nostalgic stuff. See you all next time.